Hi everyone, our subject today is Eosinophilia in Pediatrics. Basics: Eosinophilia is probably the second most common hematologic abnormality in children in the tropics after anemia. Eosinophilia is most commonly associated with exposure to an antigen, but the etiology may often be unclear. Normal absolute eosinophil count are usually 450 cl. Eosinophilia may be mild if it is more than 500 cell, moderate if it is more than 1500, or severe if it is more than 5000. History should include history of exposure to drugs that may cause hypersensitivity. Many rashes are associated with eosinophilia. These may be infectious or allergic. Travel history, particularly to tropical countries, is helpful in the diagnosis of parasitic infection. Exposure to cats and dogs may also be associated with parasites. Respiratory sign and symptom, wheezing, coughing, rales, and bronchi may indicate the presence of asthma or allergic rhinitis. If atopic disease is not suggested, a careful search for the other causes is indicated. Gastrointestinal signs and symptoms such as weight loss, diarrhea, failure to thrive may suggest either parasitic infestation or chronic gastrointestinal associated with eosinophilia. A detailed history of medication and nutritional supplement should be obtained from patients with eosinophilia. Hematologic and oncological condition may also be associated with eosinophilia, as well as many chronic disease, a family history of atopic disease, asthma, allergic rhinitis, and atopic dermatitis should be obtained. Eosinophilia may be a familial condition because eosinophilia is associated with so many conditions. An algorithm focused on more common pediatric causes. Eosinophilia, after performing history and physical examination, patient need complete blood count with differential and peripheral smear. Consider PT, PTT, liver function test, renal function test, urine analysis, chest X-ray, C-reactive protein, ESR, quantitative immunoglobulins, and IgE. If rash present, differential diagnosis could be eczema, pemphigoid, mites, scabies, urticaria, angioedema, drug reaction, and mastocytosis. If rhinitis present, this is could be allergic rhinitis, non-allergic rhinitis with Eosinophilia syndrome, NARES. Gastrointestinal symptom present, consider ESR, C-reactive protein, liver function test, serology for trichinella, toxocara, stool study for cyst and ova, and GIT referral. Differential diagnosis: eosinophilic esophagitis, eosinophilic gastroenteritis, schistosomiasis, ascariasis, strongyloides, toxocariasis, trichinellosis, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and hepatitis. If there is hepatosplenomegaly, lymphadenopathy, abnormality of the complete blood count, or smear, see the previous lecture of these diseases. The differential diagnosis: Hodgkin disease, lymphoma, leukemia, thrombocytopenia with absent radii syndrome. If there is medication, quinidine, penicillin, cephalosporin, quinolones, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, sulfasalazine, hydantoin, carbamazepine, hydrochlorothiazine, cyclosporine. If there is history, chronic history disease, this is could be immune deficiency syndrome like Wiskott-Aldrich syndrome, hyper-IgE syndrome, hyper-eosinophilic syndrome, chronic dialysis, rheumatoid arthritis, collagen vascular disease, sarcoidosis, cirrhosis, eosinophilia, myalgia syndrome, and Addison disease. If there is family history of eosinophilia, this is could be familial eosinophilia or episodic angioedema. If there is respiratory sign and symptom, history and exam suggested atopic disease. If it is yes, this is could be asthma. If it is no, there is no atopy. Patient need chest X-ray, Consider stool for cyst, ova, and parasite. Skin test for Coxedo Mycosis. Aspergillosis serology for toxocara. Sorry, serology for toxocara. Aspergillus, as we mentioned. Antimicrofilarial antibody. Differential diagnosis. Loeffler syndrome, parasitic or drug. Idiopathic acute eosinophilic pneumonia. Chronic eosinophilic pneumonia. Charcot-Sarcoidosis syndrome. Allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, tuberculosis, sarcoid, coccidomycosis, tropical pulmonary eosinophilia, filariasis. Key point. The most common cause for eosinophilia worldwide is hemophiliasis, whereas allergic disease are the leading causative factor in Western countries. Untreated eosinophilia can lead to chronic organ damage due to fibrosis and or thrombosis and hence should be treated. A child living in the tropics with eosinophilia should be investigated to rule out tropical pulmonary eosinophilia and treated with the deworming and a 3-week course of diethylcarbamazine followed by repeated count to see the response. Presence of moderate to severe eosinophilia in a child with asthma point toward the possibility of Charcot-Sarcoidosis disease or allergic pulmonary aspergillosis. Eosinophilia can also be associated with the neoplastic disease like lymphoma, B or T cell leukemia, Langerhans cell histiocytosis, solid tumor, and mastocytosis, which need to be excluded in persistent cases. Hyperisonophilic syndrome is defined by the persistent eosinophilia more than 1500 cell for more than 6 months, evidence of end organ damage but no explanation after investigation. The two variants of hyperisonophilic syndrome are myeloproliferative variant M and lymphocytic variant L. If respiratory symptoms are present and asthma is not suggested, chest X-ray should be obtained looking for eosinophilia-associated lung disease. Serologic test for toxocara may be done in children with exposure to pets, especially cats or dogs. A stool study for cyst and ova may reveal parasitic infestation. Serological and skin test for aspergillosis and coccidomycosis may be considered in specific cases. Loeffler syndrome is a transient allergic response to antigen, usually parasitic or drug. It is characterized by pulmonary infiltrate, which may resemble miliary tuberculosis, as well as by paroxysmal episode of coughing, dyspnea, and pleuricity, usually without fever. Eosinophilia may be as high as 70%. The most common parasitic cause of Loeffler syndrome are Toxocara, Toxocara canis, and Toxocara cati, Ascaris lumbricoides, Strongyloides stercolaris, and hookworm. Echinococcus granulosus may produce dyspnea, cough, and hemoptysis due to hydatid cyst in the lung. A drug that may cause Loeffler syndrome include aspirin, penicillin, sulfonamide, and imipramine. Allergic pulmonary aspergillosis is hypersensitivity reaction characterized by recurrent bronchospasm, transient pulmonary infiltrate, and bronchiectasis. It occurs in children with a chronic pulmonary disease like asthma or cystic fibrosis. Skin test as well as testing for antibody to Aspergillus antigen may aid in the diagnosis. Sarcoidosis is a chronic granulomatous disease affecting primarily the lungs. However, it may affect any organ system. Pulmonary involvement include parenchymal infiltrate, military nodule, and hilar paratracheal lymphadenopathy. Pulmonary function test findings show a restrictive pattern. Coccidomycosis is caused by coccidiosis imitans, It may occur as a primary infection. Symptoms may include fever, rash, cough, chest pain, anorexia, malaise, and occasionally hemoptysis. A majority of cases are asymptomatic. Results of chest examination are usually normal. However, chest X-ray finding may be significant for consolidation or pleural effusion. A residual cavity may develop in an area of consolidation. Diagnosis of coccidio mycosis may be done using a skin test or serology. Negative skin test results do not exclude coccidial infection. Skin test can not distinguish recent from old infection. Tropical pulmonary eosinophilia is caused by filarial infection of the lymph node and lung. Signs and symptoms include cough, dyspnea, fever, weight loss, fatigue. There are maybe rales and bronchi on chest examination. Chest X-ray show increased bronchovascular marking, discrete opacity or diffuse miliary lesion. Hepatosplenomegaly and generalized lymphadenopathy may present. Laboratory finding include eosinophilia more than 2000, increased IgE level, and high titer of antifilarial antibody. Eosinophilia seen with many immune deficiency syndrome, like Westcott-Aldrich syndrome and X-linked recessive syndrome, presenting as eczema, thrombocytopenia, and susceptibility to infection. Hyperimmunoglobulinemia E, hyper IgE syndrome, is characterized by recurrent staphylococcal abscesses involving the skin, lung, and joint. Gleach syndrome, Churg-Strauss syndrome, eosinophilia myalgia syndrome, Omenn syndrome. Medication are often associated with eosinophilia. Sometimes this is asymptomatic, but may also involve specific organ. Asymptomatic eosinophilia may occur with the quinine, penicillin, cephalosporin, or quinolones. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory and nitrofurination may cause pulmonary involvement with the eosinophilia. Cephalosporin may cause interstitial nephritis and eosinophilia. A drug reaction with the eosinophilia and systemic symptoms, DRESS syndrome, can occur with multiple medication like carbamazepine, hydrochlorothiazide, cyclosporine. Familial eosinophilia is usually benign with no associated symptom. Episodic angioedema is a familial syndrome associated with eosinophilia. Features include recurrent episode of fever, urticaria, and angioedema. Thank you for your listening.